All right, so this is a situation we've all been in. We're on the road, we're driving somewhere, and all of a sudden, you get a text. And at this point, we're all left with the same decision. Do we take the text and respond, or do we wait until we get where we're going?
I've got a thing over here at the main intersection in Lowell, texting and driving. I'm gonna like stop here in just a minute if you wanna back me up.
If you text and drive, your chances of getting pulled over are on the rise.
Basically, I'm gonna just write you a warning today, okay?
It's a new initiative by the Benton County Sheriff's Department to crack down on the bad habit, which, as it turns out, is notoriously bad in school zones.
We just wanna really try to let parents know that, hey, when you're in line to pick up your kids and you're edging forward, it's not a time to be looking at your phone. It's time to be paying attention and, you know, make sure a kid doesn't dart out in front of your car.
Sheriff's Deputy Corey Coggin is normally out busting crack dealers and gang members, but for at least the next several weeks, he and a team of officers will be catching texters, especially in school zones, but not exclusively. And it's not just texting either.
I, like so many other people, like so many of you, have taken the pledge to not text while driving. But I am guilty of one thing that, as it turns out, is just as illegal as texting while driving. I call it GPSing while driving.
Yeah, well, GPS, I understand, you know, you're trying to get somewhere, but the best option is to pull over in a safe area, type in your information you need to, and then go on with your business.
So what I did was illegal?
Yes.
Duly noted. But it doesn't end there, as this man found out when Coggin spotted him with his eyes on something in his lap.
So you're watching a video?
No, it's Pandora.
Okay.
It's a song. I don't even...
Okay, texting doesn't mean you have to be texting. It can be social media. It can be anything, okay?
Facebook and Twitter count too. Stopped at a red light? Don't even think about trying to multitask there. Coggin says cell phone related accidents have skyrocketed in the U.S. and many drivers just aren't getting the picture. A 10 by 6 inch piece of paper seems to make that picture a little clearer.
I will never text and drive again.
In the end, if you're doing anything other than calling someone or receiving a call while you're in the driver's seat and on the road, you could get pulled over. Reporting from Benton County, Darby Bybee, 4029 News.